Hello, my lovelies. I hope whenever you're watching this, you are having a great day today. My name is Rachel, and welcome to your midweek tarot reading. You're seeing this reading when you're meant to see it. It's a timeless reading, so take the energy that resonates and leave the rest. Let's get into a Moonology oracle card before we get started into tarot. And the card that just flipped for you is balance, spirituality and practicality. So you might be working on your spirituality, connecting with your higher self, connecting with your angels, manifesting. I feel there's a lot of you that are trying to manifest something into your life, be that a career, be that a new home, be that love. You are trying to manifest something into your life, but you're not taking any action, or you may not be taking any action towards it. It might be one of those things where you're sat there, you're doing spells, so to speak, you are writing your manifestations down, sleeping them under your pillow, doing all the crystal work, doing all of that, but you're not actually taking action towards the things that you want. So I feel that you need to continue to manifest, continue to connect with your higher self, with your with the higher power, however you see that, but you also need to start taking practical action towards the things that you want. You can't keep wishing and hoping for it without it actually doing anything about it. So it's time to start taking small actionable steps to bring your manifestations into your reality. I do feel, as I always felt, you take one step, the universe will take 10. The universe always takes 10 steps when you take one. But if all you're doing is sat there saying to the universe, this is what I want, this is what I want, but I'm not doing anything about it, you've got to do all the work, the universe isn't going to move. You need to do some work here. So start taking action steps. Look, and the first card that flipped was the Chariot, which means you need to start moving. So what else is tarot saying to you today? Wow, okay. We've got the Page of Pentacles, we've got the Page of Wands, we've got the Queen of Cups, the Four of Swords, and the Hanged Man. And on the bottom of the deck, you've got the King of Pentacles. So let's get straight into this. So first thing you've got is the Chariot. And like I said here, balancing spirituality and practicality, this was the first card that came out when I was talking about taking action. And this is what the Chariot card is all about. This is about taking action. It's about moving forward. It's about being the driver of your life, not the passenger, not sat in the back seat, not waiting. It feels like some of you may be, it's going to sound harsh, okay? This is a very early morning that I'm doing this, but it's going to sound really harsh. You're sat in a passenger seat with no driver to take you anywhere, expecting the car to move. The car isn't Knight Rider. If you're old enough to understand that, then you're on my level. But the car isn't Knight Rider. The car isn't going to move on its own. The only way the car is going to move, if you move your butt over from the passenger side to the driver's side and start taking action. And this card is very much telling you, start moving forward. We can't do anything without you moving forward. It feels like a very harsh message. It feels like a bit of tough love. So if you're needing a bit of tough love, move your ass over and start moving. Because if you don't, and you're just going to keep manifesting and writing stuff down, which is great, which does work, but it also makes things go a lot quicker and make things accelerate if you actually start doing something about it. Ooh, that was a bit tough, wasn't it? Page of Pentacles. There is going to be a new beginning, because you've also got the Page of Wands. So you've got two pages here. There's also a message here, or an energy here, sorry, about somebody younger. So they could have someone younger contacting you. You could, I don't know, there's somebody younger in your life that's going to have a big influence on you. And they're going to lead to a new beginning. So I feel that if you're looking for love, you could be finding love in someone that's slightly younger than you. But this is also saying that your manifestations are going to be coming in when you start taking action. And it's also showing that there is going to be a new adventure, but you've got to follow your curiosity. You've got to start you really got to start taking action. So the Page of Pentacles is all about manifestations coming in, a new beginning, increase in finances. So if you're looking for a career, you could have a message from somebody, somebody's going to be slightly younger than you, offering you a new position. Maybe you need to start applying for jobs. Maybe you need to start applying for the jobs that you don't feel that you're capable of. So you've been ignoring them. You're being guided to apply for them anyway. With the Page of Wands, this is showing there's about to be a new adventure. There's about to be something exciting happening in your life. But it will only happen when you start taking action towards it. And it's all that's coming through a lot. Nothing's going to happen unless you start moving. And when you do, things are going to start changing. You're going to start, I feel that some of you are going to have a new career, a career that you really want, a career that you don't feel that you're capable of, but you're being guided to apply for those positions or start that business that you don't feel that you can do when really you can. You just got to take that first step. And it's going to lead to a whole new adventure for you. And you're going to have lots of ideas and lots of inspiration, because when you start taking action, you take that first actionable step, it's going to lead to another idea. And then when your manifestations start coming in, it's going to inspire you and lead you to another idea. And it's like a snowball effect. But there's also energy not to rush. Move, don't rush. Remember, the slower you go, the quicker it arrives. But if you're taking no action or doing nothing about it, you're just going to be at a standstill. The next card we have here is the Queen of Cups. And this energy is literally what I just kind of said. It's like I feel that you are trying to rush things into your life. You're trying to rush love. You're trying to rush a career. You feel like you're going to run out of time. You're so focused on trying to achieve something that's in the future, and you're exhausting yourself and you're burning yourself out and you're making a lot of overwhelm and a lot of anxiety and stress. This Queen of Cups is saying, take a step back and breathe and take care of you first. Because when you take care of you, you can calm your nervous system down. When you take care of you, you can actually see things for what they really are and you can breathe. And when you do that, you're going to be able to make much clearer and much more sensible ideas for your future. So this card is saying, take a step back and take care of you, because otherwise you are going to hit burnout and it's just going to get worse and worse and worse. You're in that snowball effect. It's time to stop the snowball effect. The next card we have is the Four of Swords. This is asking you to take a step back again. And we've got the next card I just saw is the Hangman, which means exactly the same. It's about time to rest. Take some time out. Contemplate what your next move is going to be. Not out of fear. By taking care of yourself, you're going to be able to calm that nervous system down and be in the present moment. And when you are in the present moment, it's time to take a step back and rest and reflect on where you are. And that is all you need to reflect on. Where am I? And what steps do I need to take from where I am now to where I want to be? Not, I need to be here, I need to be there. How am I going to get there? Oh my God, this is stressing me out. I'm crazy. No. Where are you right now? And what step can you take right now to get you to the next step? Just the next step. Not 10 years in the future. What do you need to do right now to make tomorrow help you get one step further than you were today? And rinse and repeat that. And the final card we got here before we get to the bottom of the deck is the Hanged Man. When you take a step back, you'll be able to see things from a different perspective. And when you see things from a different perspective, you're going to be able to find the answers that you're looking for. But when you're too involved, when your anxiety is and your overwhelm is getting too much, you're not making sensible decisions. You can't see what's really there. By taking care of you, by just focusing on the next step, you're going to be able to have a much clearer picture of where you're going. And where you're going is the King of Pentacles. And the King of Pentacles is all about stability. And I feel for a lot of you, that is what you're looking for. Security and stability. And because you might not have the security and stability that you want right now, it's causing a lot of stress, a lot of overwhelm, a lot of anxiety. Which is why you're manifesting everything, but you're not taking action. But as soon as you take action, you're going to start a new beginning. There's going to be a new message coming through, an offering of some kind. You need to have a little adventure. You need to follow your inspiration. Inspiration will come the more you take action. Slower you go, the quicker you get there, because you don't make mistakes. Then you've got the Queen of Cups guiding you to take care of yourself, because otherwise you're going to get burnout. You're not going to see the clearer picture if you stay in overwhelm. Take care of yourself first. When you're doing that, take a step back, rest and contemplate what your next move is going to be. Just the next move. Not how you're going to get there in 10 years. Maybe even don't write a 10-year plan, but write a plan for the rest of the week to help you get to your goals for next week, and then repeat. When you do that, you're going to be able to see the bigger picture, and you're going to be able to see all the little things that you've missed, and realize that if you just breathe and take a step back, everything gets a little bit easier. And then on the bottom of the deck, this is going to lead to the King of Pentacles, the security, the stability that you desire, that you want. But you need to take a breath. You need to breathe through it. You need to
I can't think of the words I want to use. I'm sorry.
You need to breathe through the overwhelm and the anxiety. Thank you. And know that you are going to be stable and you are going to be secure if you just take this step. And then I'll take that step. And then that step might not work. So I'm going to have to go back a step, but then I can go forward again. It's all about rinse and repeat. But the main message here for you, my lovelies, is if you don't move, if you don't take action, nothing's going to move. That's what I've got for you today, my lovelies. Thank you for spending that time with me. I really do appreciate it. If you'd like a personal reading with me, then do check out my Etsy shop, RM Tarot. It's a link in the description box below, as well as links to my social media pages as well. I hope whenever you're watching this, you're having a great day. Enjoy the rest of your week, and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye, guys.